Welcome back to another Right to be Forgotten interactive game. Put yourself in the reviewer's shoes and play round two. And don't forget, let us know how you did in the comment section. For a reminder of the policies, check out the Right to be Forgotten explainer video and subscribe for the latest Search for Beginners videos. Answer each scenario by pressing your keyboard number keys. For mobile and tablet users, play by clicking on the timestamps in the description. All right. Question one. Meet Dr. Hall. Dr. Hall recently moved from Ireland to Finland, where she continued to practice medicine. When she set up her new website, she searched for her name in Google search, and she noticed two negative reviews from patients about her service back in Ireland. She would like the two search results to be removed from Google search. Should you delist the reviews? Select your answer now. For yes, press 1. For no, press 2. Because you haven't answered, incorrect. Dr. Hall's reviews should not be delisted. When we consider delisting information, we think about if there is a public interest in the content a user wants us to delist. For example, reviews from past clients are likely to be of legitimate interest to future clients if you provide professional services in the same industry. Let's try again. Press 3 for the next question. Time is ticking. Press 3 for the next question. You've left it too late and gone backstage. If you selected the other answer, you would have been correct. Well done. When we consider delisting information, we think about if there is a public interest in the content a user wants us to delist. For example, reviews from past clients are likely to be of legitimate interest to future clients if you provide professional services in the same industry. Ready for the next question? Press 3. Question 2. Tina, one of Dr. Hall's patients, had a serious heart attack. After her recovery, she took part in several charity events. A local blog wrote about one of the charity events and mentioned Tina as someone who recovered from a heart disease. 5 years later, Tina would like the blog post to be removed from Google search. Should you delist the article? Choose your answer now. For yes, press 5. For no, Press 4. Because you haven't answered, incorrect. The blog article can be delisted. In such a scenario, an important consideration is how sensitive or private the content is. Sensitive information might include details about someone's health, sexual orientation, race, ethnicity, or religion. We are much more likely to delist pages containing such information, especially if the requester didn't consent to making it public. Let's try again. Press 6 for the next question. Time is running out. Press 6 for the next question. Ah, you've left it too late and gone backstage. If you selected the other answer, you would have been correct. Excellent work. The blog can be delisted. In such a scenario, an important consideration is how sensitive or private the content is. Sensitive information might include details about someone's health, sexual orientation, race, ethnicity, or religion. We are much more likely to delist pages containing such information, especially if the requester didn't consent to making it public. Ready for the next question? Press 6. Question 3. Tina, in her professional life, is a business owner. Recently, she was convicted of embezzling money and has since then started a similar online business. Tina would now like the news reports about her trial and conviction to be removed from Google search. Should you delist the news reports? Press your answer now. For yes, press 7. For no, press 8. Time is ticking. because you haven't answered. Incorrect. The news report should not be delisted. If the information relates to a criminal conviction, we consider the public's interest in protecting themselves from the possibility of similar future crimes. We may also refer to local standards around when convictions expire or are eliminated from a criminal record. Ready for the final summary? Press 9. Press 9 for the final summary. You've left it too late and gone backstage. If you selected the other answer, you would have been... Correct! Nice job. The news reports should not be delisted. If the information relates to a criminal conviction, we consider the public's interest in protecting themselves from the possibility of similar future crimes. We may also refer to local standards around when convictions expire or are eliminated from a criminal record. Press 9 to jump into the final summary. Well done! You've completed round 2 of the Right to be Forgotten game. As you can see from Dr. Hall and Tina's scenarios, deciding if information should be delisted from Google search can be tricky. Please note that none of these factors are absolute. Frequently, a case presents considerations that point in different directions, and we will carefully consider all of them when making a decision. To discover more about our policies, check out our Help Center article in the description and our Right to be Forgotten explainer video. If you haven't already, don't forget to play round 1. Let us know how you did in the comments section. And for the latest Search for Beginner videos, hit the subscribe button. Thank you so much for playing round 2 of Google's Right to be Forgotten game. To play again, press 0.